Next one. Nice and bright. First thing she does is get her speed. How's my speed? Too fast, too slow, just right. Go on with it, Lauren. Go on with it. This is nice. This is nice. Beautiful. Good fence. Look at the next jump. Walking and chewing gum. You're doing two things at the same time. Keep out your pace, go on a little. Good, that's fine. Get your lead, left lead. Look at that next jump. Look at that next jump. How's my speed? This looks nice. This looks nice. Beautiful. When I'm going to the fence, get that lead, look at that next jump. When I'm going to the fence, there's three ways that can come up. Just right, short, or long. And I've got to have a canter, but she's got a good canter. A little long, good. Beautiful, and stop straight. Good. Next one. When I'm going to the fence, it can only come up one of three ways. It's going to come up just right, it's going to come up short, it's going to come up long. If I'm hooking along like this, and it's going to come up short, is that an option? I can't shorten any further, but I'm getting there too close. So that's not a good canter to have. Your canter has to be one that you can slow down for the short one, or you can lengthen for the long, or just stay the same. She had a good canter. Good, look at it. Nice canter, good speed. Good. Came up a little short. She's in a good position. Super. Her eyes are good. She's looking. Beautiful. Beautiful. She's got to get the lead. Change the lead. Nice. Good. He began to get a little fast. Settle. And halt on that straight line. So, they're really well done, pretty even in the rhythm and the pace throughout the round, until right at the end it got a little bit fast, not too bad, but it got a little bit fast on the way to the last line. They had a little bit of a bold one in, and then she had to shorten to get the last one in. Good job. As much as we would like to not see change, we'd like it to come up just right all the time. Much better to do what she did, which was make it work. He got a little bit away from her at the end, and she said, oh, come back. Little pace, little pace, little pace. First thing first, as you get into, you know where you're going? Okay. So hang on, walk, walk. You jump this first jump. You jump this first jump. I liked it, it was nice. Your horse landed on the outside incorrect lead. She went to a trot, she picked up the correct lead, I like that. But now, as she went into the canter, her canter was like this. Is this good for all three choices? Is it good for a short one, a nice one, or a long one? It's a little bit dopey, you know? It's one that can definitely go on, but it can't really shorten. You need to get going. And your thing here, pick up that canter, get the pace that's right before you get into range of the fence, like I was talking about with that first one. So, you did your simple change, which is nice. Now here, rather than here saying, all right, how is this going to come up at the fence? At this point, say, my canter's too slow, I need to get going. Then you begin to work that fence out of a better situation, as opposed to, we're slow and pokey here, now, how's the fence going to come up, and I'm having to deal with it out of a less than great situation. Get that ideal canter all the time. First thing you do is, how's my speed? Too fast, too slow, just right. And when you pick up that lead there, know from his history that he's a lovely, quiet type. I need to get going. Micah, on the other hand, her horse is going a bit. Maybe she has to say, settle. Let's see it right from the beginning. Go to the right. You don't want to see it from the beginning, this first jump. Look here, this way, head that way. Head that way, we're gonna start with this one. This is your first one. Nice trot, nice trot. Forward, good. First thing you ask, how's my speed? It's a little slow, just a touch slow, go on a bit. This is nice, this is nice. Fine, get that lead, look at the jump. Look at the jump, Tanner. Go on, go on. Beautiful, fine. Look at that next jump. Look at that next jump. Beautiful. Switch your lead. Look at this jump while you fix your lead. Look at it, look at it. Good. Beautiful, stop straightening. You know, I'm a little bit conflicted there. Well done, nicely done. I'm a little bit conflicted there in that as much as I want to keep things simple and practice doing not too much, you know, when I'm helping someone, I'm sort of doing it from if I was actually riding first, how's it going? How's my speed? How's my turn? How's my corner? All that. And I really found myself as she was doing it. I was like, do this, do this, do this, do this. There's a lot to get done. You know, here, we're gonna jump this, travel straight, how's my lead, fix my lead, start looking at the next jump, how's my speed, am I too fast, too slow, just right? That's an awful lot to get done there. So, that's where you're trying to find that happy medium in training of horses and riders, is to do simple things. She's ready to progress on it. She did this very nicely, so she's ready to start getting pushed a little bit. All right. Next one. Good pace. Good pace. Beautiful. Great. You keep working heads. I get up off of my horse's back. I anchor down in my heels, but I'm up off of my horse's back and my arms are following. You watch that your hands don't get locked down. But the beauty of this jump here is it's gonna come up just right, short or long. It came up short, and that's a place where you don't wanna be sort of seated in the back seat here, waiting like this, and if he leads long, then I get left behind. If he leads short like that, I'm sort of stuck and I'm not with him. You were in a nice position to be with him. That was great. Very well done. So we'll sort of build on this. Everyone, just as you're finishing up here, you can take a moment to a walk in that back rein. And this is a nice place to think, a nice time to be thinking about what you experienced today, what was good, what was bad. Every horse I get on, I want to think about what I liked, what I want to improve on tomorrow, what worked well for me so that I make sure to incorporate that into what I do tomorrow. For you and your horse, I love that long rein. He's a little bit of a waiter in getting him to sort of break out of the shell of that nice long walk. On the loose rein on the buckle at the beginning, that encourages him to do this as opposed to these little short dainty steps. All right, well done, one and all. Hello.